Nossa, você está organizando coisas. Foi mais que o melhor de fechar o que está acontecendo. I wanted to once more stress the point that a national resolution should be a unifying document. And it's my belief of the group grant and set himself to accept that the zero singular criteria for judging us. And we have done our best, we've been invested in very many more works than those that have been in the process. But it relies on you, the artists, to make sure that it is a unifying document. We love you so much. But you have to compete in the spirit of legal support. I also wanted to commend the government of Thailand. I think I'm sure your Caribbean colleagues have never seen a series of events that have been attended by government of Thailand for three consecutive days.
Pleasure, and I know you.
understanding of talking with and working with a private institution. So many people who just have the faith to keep working every day, because art is a self-starting occupation. Civil servants in the city are going to their desk and things come into you and you respond to them. But art, you have to sit there and it comes from in here, which is why we're talking about ideas. So I think it's commendable that as the rest of the said, so many people have been still thinking and sharing outside is trying to find methods by which you express those ideas. Because that's a challenge, you have to continue them to yourselves. Be proud of what you listen to this competition. Look at what you've done. Keep on being challenged by your own ambition and your own dreams, your own inspiration. But also, of course, be excited and challenged by the work of your peers, by those who think are harder than you, because when you stand in front of the work here in an institution like this, and yes, that's the way it looks like in you. We hope you will be even more excited and inspired to do more work. And if you do feel like that, then you feel here at National Gallery, job we set out to do. So on behalf of the chair and staff of the committee, and the committee, myself and staff, we just want to say once again that the precious thing about the media. Many congratulations to the artists and the office of the work of the world in the future. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Frida, and entire management of the Castellani House and workers. Also, there were other institutions such as the Borough School of Art, which did the receiving and documentation of the work. And this Father Ramsay was connected in that with a staffer. And of course, Mr. Alfred Liverpool, Mr. Monroe, and others at the Indian National Museum, who at very late notice accommodated us to use their space. Challenge all around. And I think we have met the challenge well all around. We now have a bit more breathing space and we think 14. We could look forward 2 years ahead to another exhibition. Now we have with us here the Honourable Minister of Culture, Youth and Sport, who has been in this competition and in the planning and the management committee meetings. And so we'd like to invite him to come forward, say a few words, and to declare the exhibition open.
Thank you very much, Alec. Members of the board of Castellani House, who are the judging panel, the members of the planning and management committee, members of the artistic community who are here with us, our friends. It's indeed a tremendous pleasure for the ministry to have hosted this series of events related to art. As I said last night, I think for quite some time now, we feel some sense of injustice because we've had all these well-established prizes and they were always clamoring for something that can recognize their works. I think this event, this particular competition and exhibition is really validated what they've been calling for all these years. And we and the government, we've been very pleased to have facilitated this. We want to go further because we feel that we have a lot of talented people here, and once they're given the opportunity, they'll go to even greater heights. And while you started this competition, we've been at it every 2 years, in between that, we want to do other things that can keep the momentum going. And perhaps would be maybe closer collaboration between the ministry, Castellani, so that maybe we can do many more joint events. I think perhaps we need to create more spaces so that artists can put up their work. One of the things that we were contemplating at the National Cultural Center, the foyer to put up artwork here for various artists, perhaps have a little coffee shop at the bottom there so that people can come and chat and look at great art, and if they like to buy a piece, they can get a good piece of art. know, create other environments. And I think if we do that, we'll get more people appreciating art in our country. You know, for some people that perhaps feel that something like going to an art gallery or appreciating a piece of art calls for, you know, a certain level of people. We gotta make art more accessible. People must not feel intimidated by artworks or coming to a gallery. And I think if we start explaining more of that, perhaps there are schools involved and so forth, we'll change that attitude. Apart from getting more people to appreciate art, we also have to use maybe our media to talk a lot more about the creative people that we have in our society. Not a lot of attention sometimes given to our creative people. And in the case of our artists and so forth, you know, we need to have a little bit more media attention on them. You know, over this last 2 days, 2-3 years, we have had, I would say, a very important symposium going on masquerade and the development of masquerade art, art form, the origins, the history, and so forth. We have people looking at masquerade in the Caribbean and so forth. I haven't seen anything in the press about it. Maybe it might have been a photograph or anything, nothing. And one of the reasons why we did this symposium is because we feel that art form is dying. Right? And if we lose that, we're losing an integral part of our history. And yet, something is, I would say, very important to us as a people, we're not seeing, or maybe the friends in the media maybe don't really understand the significance of it. So I hope that we can change that, maybe some of the findings that could emerge out of the symposium. But we can change that because we really have to play an important role. We have to shape people's opinion, views, and we can use that to educate. We can use that to change how people think about some of these things like art and, you know, other cultural things in our society. I would agree with Dr. Luke Ryan. Sometimes as a country, we fight too much. And we fight over critical things, I would say. But culture, and I would say sport, offers us opportunity where we can create safe spaces. We're not looking at each other because of our politics, but we can look at each other because, you know, we're Ghanese. And when somebody's playing, whether it's a cricket match or football, or we're coming to appreciate great art, it's about celebrating ourselves and appreciating what we've created. And I think if we create more spaces like that, it would help us to be, you know, a better nation. So there are times for us to debate and fight. That's necessary. Through conflict, we get an evolution of things too. But we must also find the safe spaces where we can talk and converse and debate ideas without getting too rancorous. And I think these spaces provide that. So for all the various reasons, there are many, many things why we do these things. And we in the ministry were very pleased by the outcome. And I must once again show the ministry's gratitude to the panel of judges. I think they did a marvelous job. And we were very pleased that everybody readily agreed to be part of this panel. And we were very pleased with the work. Because of the quality of our judges, I would say, I think everybody, you know, we are leaving here better in a sense. I also like to thank the planning and management committee. You know, these guys did a fabulous job. They were meeting in my office almost every Tuesday. And then in between, I think Alan was going about doing things almost every day. And as I got closer to the exhibition, I think he was probably doing this thing on a 24-hour basis. Because anytime you call him, he got some other detail to tell you about. And he's a very meticulous man, and I think because of his attention to be until we have such a success. The corporate people who will support us, again, we did not have any resistance from them. We were thinking that we needed to have a catalog to document not only the works, but maybe say something about the artists themselves. And as soon as we thought of the idea, Mr. Tracy said, that's going to be my project. I'm going to get this done. And, you know, when he called the guys, everybody agreed. I think by next week we should have that catalog out. So, you know, there will be something that documents what is happening here. There's so many pieces that we need to document here. And we truly want to use the space in between now and the next competition to really mobilize the artistic community, get people together, let's see what we can advocate for, what we need to change. I know some people have been thinking that we need to create studios for artists to work. Some people have been saying to me we need to create galleries where people can visit and they can sell their works. There's so many ideas. And so maybe between now and the next competition, there's so much more work to do.